Hi, you two students. Welcome back. My name is Ella and I'll be your teacher today. We're up to lesson 6 and I wonder if you've been able to put your learning into a book of some sort, a scrapbook, a spare book, so we can collect our learning as we go along. Before we start, let's have a think about what our last lesson was. It was about doubles and we made this wonderful double chance for us to remember what 3 and 3 make, just off the top of our heads. 3 and 3 make 6. And then we added some really tricky ones like, what's 8 plus 8 or double 8? And if we looked at our chart, we'd be able to see 16. I hope you're able to share that with somebody too. Okay, today's lesson is about counting efficiently. And to do that, we're going to need a few things. Our book and something to write on. We're going to need our things to count yet again. And we're going to need, this time, a jar. Your jar might not look like this. It might be larger or smaller. Just have a look around where you are and see if you can find one, because we're going to put some things inside it today. So today, our learning intention will be to estimate and count large collections efficiently. Efficiently means we're not going to waste any time. We're going to do it in a timely manner. Okay, so no counting by ones. That takes too long. We're also going to estimate and count. Now remember, we've estimated before. An estimate means a guess. So we're going to look at something and have a think about what it could be. It's going to help us get to our answer and check that our answer might be right. Now sometimes our guesses or estimates can be reasonable, or sometimes they can be really off the chart. So if I look down at a handful of things and I say, I estimate 1, I don't think that's reasonable. It's going to be more than 1. Or if I look at a handful of things and go, I think that might be 1,002. No, that's not a reasonable estimate. So we're trying to guess in a roundabout number that makes sense. Okay, so it's really important to estimate before we count. Now, we'll know we can do this properly when we start counting efficiently using tens. So here we go. All right, let's start with a warm-up. It's a number talk. How many dots can you see? Okay, let's put some in parts. These are the parts that I saw. I can see 3, 3, and 3. I wonder if you did too. There's lots of different answers to this question. I can see another part. Maybe this is the one you saw. I saw 4, 2, and 3. Let's write that down. My first one was 3, 3, and 3. And my second number sentence was, remember, 4, 2, and 3. What was your total for the dots you can see? I wonder if it was mine. Let's have a look. Three parts, 3 parts, and 3 parts make 9 whole. And 4 parts, and 2 parts, and 3 parts also make 9 whole. Well done. Good warm up. Okay, let's start our task today. We're going to grab a handful of something near you, a collection. So maybe you could bring back your pasta, some dry pasta collection. Maybe you have some fun toys at home. I'm going to use some gum nuts today that I found near my place. So first of all, I'm going to estimate a small handful in front of me. Okay, I guess, estimate or think that I have 15 gum nuts in front of me. Now, let's check. I'm going to use a tool today that we'll be making a little bit later, which is a 10 frame. You may have used one of these before, and they are a wonderful piece of equipment to help us count and use our base 10 model. All right, so let's start. Remember, I estimated there are 15 gum nuts. That's going to help me make sense of my answer. Here we go. So I have 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect. I have 10 gum nuts on my 10 frame. I'll need another 10 frame now. So here we go. That's a trick. That's a funny little one. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now remember, I think that was my estimate. 15. But I'm going to keep going because my estimate was a reasonable amount. Oh, look, it's perfect. I have 10 and 10 with zero ones. So a 10 and a 10 with zero ones will give me 20. My estimate was 15. It's a reasonable estimate. So I now have 20 using my 10 frame. So now I know I have 20 gum nuts. I'm going to put them in my jar. So I know there's 20. I'm going to fill the jar up now to the very top. There'll be a few more. You can be the judge of your jar a little later. Okay, so I've filled my jar up with a whole lot of gum nuts. I know there's 20 in there already, and now I've added some more. So my estimate, I'm going to go for 45. I think there are 45 gum nuts now in my jar. All right, how do we count this? We count it efficiently by using our 10 frames. All right, so here we go. Okay, here are my last lot of gum nuts. I'm not going to make all 10 here, so let's have a look what I've ended up with. I have 10, 20, 30, 40, four lots of 10, and I have 8 more. So I have 48. Let's record that so we know we've got it right. I think I have, this is my estimate, I think I have 45 gum nuts. What do I have? Let's draw this. Now, to draw a 10 frame, and we're going to get very good at that, we start with a rectangle and we draw a line in the middle. Then I want to put four lines here to give me my 5 spaces. So I'm going to look near the middle and put one just to the side to make my first 2. And now I'm going to make my next 3. Let's just check I've got that right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 below makes 10. So now I have my 10 frame of my gum nuts. Let's get very good at drawing these now because I need to draw 4 more. And what I might do is I might try and copy from my first one. So I'll line the first one up and go all the way down. The second one. And so on. So now I have my 4 10 frames. Let's check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I do. These ones got big, but that's okay. So here we go. I have 20, 30, 40 gum nuts, and one more in the middle, just off to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's count by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, I have, let's look at these in parts and wholes. 4 lots of 10 and an 8. Let's write that as a number sentence too. I have 40 plus 8. I have 48 gum nuts. And this is a very good estimate because it's close. Remember, it's not, I didn't think there was only 2 there, and I didn't think there were 500 there. I thought it was a roundabout, so it's a very good estimate, and it helps me check that I've got my answer right. Okay, so let's recap. We made it, we drew it, and we wrote it. And that's how I'm going to record my findings. Okay, now before we get to our task, let's just do 3 more examples, just so we know we've got this. Remember, we're using 10 frames to count efficiently. All right, here we go. Our first example's here. So let's have a look at our fun teddy bears. So we have 10 frame covered, so it must be 10. So we have 10, and how many more? Let's have a look. 10, let's count by twos. 2, 4, 6. We have 10 and 6 ones. 10 and 6, 16. Okay, let's try the next one. Here's our gum nuts again, and we have a 10, a 10, a 10, and how many more? This one's up to you. Have a think about what is the amount we have in front of us. Okay, let's try the answer. I hope you said 10, 10 and 10 is 10, 20, 30 and 2 more. I can recognize that's a 2. I don't need to count. So here we go. 30 and a 2. 32. Well done. And our last one. I think you can see what's happening here too. We're getting a little bit larger as we go along. Okay, here we go. Lots of fun cubes in front of us in groups of 10 because we're using our 10 frames. So, I wonder what your answer is here. All right, let's check. We have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 groups of 10 make 50, and 1 on the end. You're right, it's 51. Well done. So here's our examples. Let's get to it for your task. Let's find out what you need to do after our lesson today. Today we were able to count large collections using our 10 frames, and that is counting efficiently. So well done. Your task is to find a jar. This one used to have salsa in it, and pop in some collections that you have near you. Might be gum nuts, it might be pasta, it could be a whole lot of things, depending on how big or small your jar is. So we're going to pop them in here just like I did, and you're going to do the activity that I did. So remember, when I filled my jar, I wrote, I think I have my estimate, a reasonable estimate. I drew my 10 frames, Remember how I drew them? A rectangle, cut it through the middle, and 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. That can be a little bit tricky. And then pop your collection on top of your 10 frames. So you might like to draw them in your book, or you might have a piece of paper. So we're going to use our 10 frames to count efficiently and find out just how many things are in your jar. Okay, enjoy doing your maths. Enjoy writing it down. I hope you have a good time. I'll see you next lesson. Bye.